The new version of NanoBanana just dropped a few days ago, and it's already all over the internet. It's called NanoBanana Pro, also known as Gemini Free. Today we're doing a straight breakdown of the new generation versus the previous version. What actually got better? What's just marketing? And what matters when you're using it for real work? No theory, just side-by-side proof. I'll be running everything inside Photoshop with the Astrea plugin. But you can run it in any tool or service that has access to this model. I've already made a video about it, so if you're interested, I will link it in the description. So let's get into it. To use it, just select the area, add a prompt, and choose the model. Let's add a lady lying in the bed. In this case, we will go with the new NanoBanana Pro. Then, simply click the Submit button. The generations take more time than the previous version. In this case, it took around 27 seconds, but I sped it up. Is it worth the time? Here is the result. I think it did an amazing job. I really like it. The style and lighting match the scene perfectly. Also, there are no artifacts or weird details on the person. It's not perfect out of the box though. The output is slightly shifted. In this case, we can easily correct it. I will scale it a bit to match the original image. Also, I like to mask it out a bit. Great, now let's see how it compares with the old model. In this example, the new model did a way better job, and I think it's worth using it. The generation is way more stylish and was done with more taste. The old model's generation would not be usable. We would need more work with the prompt and maybe with the reference. Also, there are artifacts on the feet. While we are comparing, it is worth mentioning that the new model is 4 times more expensive. One generation with the Gemini 2.5 costs only 4 cents, but with Gemini 3, the cost goes up to 16 cents. On top of that, if you use the option with the upscaled 4K output, one generation will cost 26 cents. And that price jump is exactly why knowing free workflows matters. If you want NanoBanana level results without NanoBanana level costs, check out our AI course. We show you how to build a full comfy UI pipeline using free models like Quen, so you're not locked into pricey generations. But remember, AI is just a tool. Without strong 3D fundamentals, it won't help you create anything truly original. Build your foundation first, then use AI to push your visuals further and faster. And honestly, now it's the best time to jump in. Our Black Friday sale is live. Get up to 30% off courses and bundles. Enroll now and level up your skills with us. Let's continue with our examples. Here, I want to replace the chairs in the image with this reference. We can easily add a reference from the layer by clicking this button. Then, let's add a prompt to replace the chairs. Here is the result with the old model. Not too bad, but the position of the chairs is different. Also, we've got one extra old chair. Not usable. Now let's see the new model. Way better. The placement is perfect. Moving on. I wanted to add a small fluffy dog on the sofa, and it did an amazing job. The dog was created with the Pro version, and it looks very natural. I could easily use it in the final render. There are no issues here. It even added a nice warm tint to the pillows from light reflections. Nice! For comparison, this one was done with version 2.5, and it's good enough. I prefer the other version, but I could work with this too. The only issue here is the visible seam, which we'd need to remove. Here, I've added two bartenders behind the bar. The new model did an amazing job. No issues here, except maybe they look like twins, which we can easily fix with one more generation. The old model's generation is not bad either. But here we have the issue with the alignment of the background. It would be hard to fix this example as the background is very busy. With the generations I did today, it seems like the new model is doing a way better job with the alignment. It doesn't work well all the time. Here, I wanted to replace the chairs as well. I've used this image as a reference. This time, the old model didn't even try. It only replaced the material, but only on two chairs. The new model didn't work either, but for a different reason. It did an amazing job with the bar stools. They match perfectly, but the proportions of the whole generation are way off. There is no way we can align it. Not sure what the issue is here, but it kept happening with more generations too. Here, the old model did a better job. Let me show you. I wanted to replace the lamp the same way as in the previous example. The old model did a good job. We only need a bit of masking on the edges, and we are good to go. The new model did completely opposite of what I was asking. It kept the lamp and replaced the background. Not usable. We can replace materials too. Here, I wanted to replace the black tiles on the wall with this marble texture. We can do it the same way as with replacing the objects. Add the layer as a reference image. Select the area you want to generate, type the prompt, and submit. Here is the result using the Gemini 2.5, the old model. The main issue is that the white wall was replaced as well, which I didn't want. Other than that, not too bad. From the positives, this time we have a perfect alignment using the old model, while the new model didn't deliver in that front. The quality of the generated image is way better though. I like the scale of the texture more. Also, the white balance and contrast match the scene perfectly, which was not the case with the old model. Unfortunately, there is no way to align this generation to the original image, making it unusable. Unfortunately, with tools like this, we don't have full control over the result. Sometimes we are lucky, and sometimes we get a result like this. Next, let me show you how to change the style of the entire image. I will use this image from my visualization course as an example. It has a lot of details, so it will be challenging. It is a 5K image, so we will also see how the resolution will hold up. To change the season, simply select the whole image and type the prompt. Here is the result generated with the old model. Very low res and not so nice. Not much to talk about. Here is what the new model did. A bit better, but the higher resolution looks like it was heavily upscaled. We have a lot of artifacts. It's unusable. As I mentioned briefly in the pricing section, with the new model, we can also output 4K resolution by upscaling the image. You can set it up here. When using this option, the cost will go up by 10 cents, from 16 to 26 cents. Here is the upscaled result. When zooming out a lot or viewing on the small screen, it looks okay at first glance. If you zoom in though, you will see a lot of artifacts and weird upscaling. Not worth it in this case. Let me show you another example. This time, I wanted to change the season in this image to winter. Here is the old model. Simply put, I don't like it. It almost feels like the whole scene is sprinkled with powdered sugar. Let's see how the new model did. A bit better, but still not great. I would not use it. The car doesn't look too bad, but other than that, I don't like it. And finally, let's check the new model 4K output. Way better. It went a bit overboard with the icicles, but overall I could work with that. There are some issues, but we might be able to fix them with more generations. I really like the foreground with the tire tracks. Alright. That's it for a comparison. Hopefully it gives you a clear sense of when NanoBanana Pro is worth it and when the old model still holds up. Don't forget about the Black Friday sale, the discounts like this won't happen again for the whole year. If you want some reward tests and workflows like this, hit subscribe and check the links in the description. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye bye!